The garage. Here we go. All right, welcome back to the channel. Real quick, we're just going to tell you a story about my buddy scratching my motorcycle. Kind of upset about it, but let's talk about it. The mess in the garage.
Okay, so I got this extension cord right here, and it came with a remote control. So the theory is that I press the thing, and then my lights come up, right? That's not working, but I still plug it in, and I press the button. And it actually works.
Roking, baby. Yeah. Ooh, roguelike. Double yeah. Okay, so I don't know if some people understand this or not, but maybe in case you don't, or maybe you're new into the motorcycle community and the things that we do in the motorcycle, you know, riding bikes and things like that, is that you don't touch people's bike without people letting you or giving you permission. I thought that was something that everybody understood, but apparently it's not. Now, I'm just going to tell you a quick story, just real quick, because it happened to me the other day, and it actually upset me big time. It was pretty upsetting. I kind of let it go. I really did. I had to pray about it. That's how bad it was. I was like, man, this thing is getting me upset, because I'm going to tell you, my 2009 Roguelite, which I got right here, is so clean, right? Really, really clean. It has 30,000 miles, but when I got it, one of the things that impressed me the most is how clean it was. Like, I was in shock, you know. Whoever had it did a really good job making sure the bike was inside a garage and the bike was just taken care of. So here's the story.
So I got a mess here in the garage, so you're going to have to excuse me, but here's the bike right here.
So I'm talking to a friend of mine at work, and I'm telling him about, you know, how fun it is to ride a motorcycle, how much of a blast, how we go to different places and all this stuff. And we're having a great conversation. I got to tell you, it's fun, right? So we're talking about this, and out of nowhere, I got my bike parked on my job, and out of nowhere, another friend from work, right? He was like, yeah. And he obviously mentioned the guy's name. And he goes like, yeah, Joe. And he jumps. And as he jumps in the air, like, he literally throw himself in the motorcycle by grabbing my apes right here. But as he jumps in the air, he kicks my saddlebag so bad. Let me show it to you guys.
I think it's going to be difficult for the camera to pick it up. But there's a scratch here coming down this way. And there's another scratch here going down this way. So you have a scratch right here and a scratch right here. Now, I'm going to tell you,
it's really not that bad. Like, it's really not crazy. I think that with a little bit of buffing or something like that, I could buff it out and it's going to come out. Let me know down in the comment section below if you guys have, you know, things like this, or if you guys have like a super superficial, I guess, scratch. What do you use to buff it out? So again, it's really not that bad. I think that it's going to be buff out with no issues, and I'll be all right. I got a good buddy, Jeremy, that does a lot of painting and things like that. So even if I get to the point that I need somebody to paint it, I'm sure he will give me a good deal, right? But again, it's really not that bad. But the thing that kind of like mind-blowing to me was like, some people just don't get it. You know, I thought that it was common knowledge that you ask to somebody for, hey man, can I get on your bike? Can I see how your bike feel? Can I, you know, sit on it and make sure that, you know, maybe it's a good fit to me? And to me specifically, I would never do that. Like, I, you know what I'm saying? Like, I don't jump on people's bike. I don't touch people's bike unless they ask or they give me the permission, or it's somebody that I really, really know. You know, I got buddies at work that we really friend that we could ask, hey man, can I see how your bike feels? Or to the fact, hey man, can I ride your bike to see how it feels? And, you know, again, you know, you have those close friends that you may be able to do that, but there is really a respect and there is really a way to do it. And obviously, if you know that it's not okay, it's not okay, right? You're not going to ask people to let me ride your bike unless you really know that person, or let me jump in your bike and let me see how it feels unless you really know that person. I think it was just like common knowledge that you just don't do that. But here's the thing, you know, this person, I don't want to mention names, obviously, jumping the bike, hit it pretty bad.
I mean, this whole thing was like covering dirt, covering everything. So like, I cleaned it up really good. I tried to like clean it very, very good, which it really came out good. Like, you barely, I mean, you see the scratch here pretty good. This one right here, not that bad. But this one, you see it pretty good.
And like I say, I just, you know, I was just like, okay, it is what it is. You know, I had to like pray about it. I'm like, Lord, give me the strength to be cool about this. I know it was not something that it was purposely made. It was just an accident, right? It was just an accident. And it is what it is. I'm just going to clean it myself and fix it myself. So it was just an accident. But I'm like thinking, to myself, like, you know, people got to know this. You just don't jump in people's bike unless you've been given permission or unless somebody said that it's okay for you to jump in somebody's bike. It's just common knowledge, I thought. But again, it is what it is. My 2009 Road Glide, just want to give you a quick update. I just don't want to complain and about it. My 2009 Road Glide is an awesome bike. I love it. I'm having a great, you know, a ton of fun with it. I'm enjoying myself really, really good with this motorcycle. And I'm just so happy about it that I got it. So let me know what you think. Put comments down below. And as always, gotta send control.